In this video, we can solve a question from the UK Maths Olympiad Competitions for Girls 2022. Find all positive integers of n, a, b, with a is less than or equal to b, such that n factorial equals 2 to the power a plus 2 to the power b. Then how to find all positive integers of three variables with one equation? In general, we just pick one variable and try to narrow down the search range. So here, let's look at n. So let's start from n factorial. N factorial equals 2 to the power a plus 2 to the power b. Because both a and b are positive integers, so their minimum value is 1. So then here is bigger than or equal to 2 to the power 1 plus 2 to the power 1. Just using one minimum value for both a and b. And here equals 4. Then we have n factorial is bigger than or equal to 4. But 4 is bigger than 2. 2 equals 2 factorial. So that means n is bigger than 2. So this implies n is bigger than or equal to 3. So now let's mark this result with 1 star. So next, let's look at this given condition. So a is less than or equal to b. So let's see what happens if a is equal to b. So if a equals b, so then this equation, n factorial equals 2 to the power a plus 2 to the power b, so here just a, then equals 2 times 2 to the power a, then just equals 2 to the power of a plus 1. So then we have n factorial equals 2 to the power of a plus 1. Because here n is bigger than or equal to 3, so then on the left-hand side, n factorial, it has a factor of 3. But on the right-hand side, it only has a factor of 2. So that means there's no solution for this case. So no solution when a equals b. So that means a is less than b. So now let's mark this result with 2 stars. Okay, so now let's look at our equation. So the equation is n factorial equals 2 to the power a plus 2 to the power b. Because here a is less than b, so then for these two, they have common factor 2 to the power a. So let's take out the common factor 2 to the power a out, then here, then 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a. So now we have this equation. So that's n factorial. Then equals 2 to the power a times 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a. So now let's mark this equation with the 3 stars. Okay, so now let's look at the first case. So the first case is when n equals 3. When n equals 3, so here is a 3 factorial. So then here, 3 factorial, then equals this part. 2 to the power a times 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a. Then 3 factorial, just 2 times 3. Then here, 2 to the power a, then this part. Because b is bigger than a, and both a and b are positive integers. So that means, so here, so b minus a is bigger than or equal to 1. So that means this part is an odd number. And here, so 2 means 2 to the power 1. So then we have a equals 1. So a equals 1. Then this part, this odd number, 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a, then equals 3. So then use move 1 to the right hand side, then use 1 replace a. So then we have b 2 to the power b minus 1, then equals 2 to the power 1. Then here b minus 1 equals 1. So then we have the solution for a is 1, then b here is 2. So then we have the first set of solution for n a b. So it equals a is 3, a is 1, b is 2. So this is the first set of solution of the equation. Now let's see the second case. Second case is when n equals 4. Again, based on this equation, the equation in with 3 stars. So for this one, so here's a 4 factorial. Then here, 4 factorial, then equals 2 to the power of a, then times 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a. Then here, 4 factorial, which is 1 times 2 times 3 times 4, combine 2 with 4. So then here, just 2 to the third times 3, then equals 2 to the power a, then times 1 plus 2 to the power of a, b minus a. Again, because b minus a is bigger than or equal to 1, so here, this part is our number. So now we have the following. So then a equals 3, this is the power. So a equals 3, then this part, 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a, then equals 3, this 3, then equals 3. Then move 1 to the right hand side, use 3, replace a, then we have 2 to the power of b minus 3, then equals 2. Then b minus 3, then equals 1. So now we have a solution. This is for a, this is for b. So then here, so a equals 3, then b equals 4. So then the second set of the solution for n, a, b is n is a 4. Then a is a 3, then b is a 4. So this is the second set of a solution of the equation. Now let's see the next case. So next case is when n is bigger than or equal to 5. So now let's see the equation. So n factorial equals 2 to the power a times 1 plus 2 to the power of b minus a. Because here n is bigger than or equal to 5, then for 5 factorial, it equals 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times 5. So that means it has a factor of 3 and 5. So that means when n is bigger than or equal to 5, so n factorial has a factor of 3 and 5. So that implies n factorial, when divided by 3 times 5, it has a remainder of 0. So here, so mod 3 times 5, which is 15. Since the left-hand side of the equation has a remainder 0 when divided by 3 times 5, so that means the right-hand side also has a remainder 0. Because here's a 2. 2 and 3, 5 are 3 prime numbers. So then 2 to the power a is not divisible by 3 times 5. That means this part. So that means this part, 1 plus 2 to the power of a b minus a, has a remainder 0. 1 divided by 15. But now let's look at a fact. So for any positive integer m, then 2 to the power m, 1 divided by 15, it has a remainder either 1 or 2 or 4 or 8. 1 divided by 15. You can easily check it. So when m equals 1, 2, 3, the remainder just 2, 4, 8. When m equals 4, 2 to the power 4 equals 16. So 1 divided by 15, so then 2 to the power 4, 16 has a remainder 1. So then after that, you just start to cycle. So then this is the result. So then use this result for this part. So now let's see. So then for this part, 1 plus 2 to the power b minus a. So then for this part, remainder is 1, 2, 4, 8. Then plus 1, so then the remainder is every 1 plus 1. So then the remainder is a 2, then this one is a 3, then this is a 5, then this one 9. So 1 divided by 15. So that means this part. So that means 1 plus 2 to the power b minus a, the remainder is not a 0. 1 divided by 15. You see, there's a contradiction. You see here, so that means this part is not divisible by 15. So remainder is not 0. But here means the remainder is 0. So that means the left-hand side, 1 divided by 15, the remainder is 0. But the right-hand side has a remainder is not a 0. So that means for n is bigger than equal to 5, this equation, so n factorial equals 2 to the power a plus 2 to the power b has no solution. So then combine the solutions in 1 and 2. So then here are the solutions for n, a, b. So 1 is, so n is a 3, so then a is a 1, b is a 2. Or the second one, so n is a 4, so a is a 3, then b is a 4. So they are the solutions of this equation. Thanks for watching.